If you use Microsoft Word, I've got a couple of tips that are going to make you faster and more efficient. Stay tuned for these. Hey, welcome to another Tech Tip Tuesday. My name is Liron Segev, where I make technology simple. So that's what we do here every Tuesday. I'll give you some tips and tricks on how to be more efficient and get more out of your system. So take a moment if you're new here, smash that subscribe button, little notification bell, hit that as well so you don't miss one of these tips. And let's get started.
Right, if you've ever been given a document that's full of images with an instruction to do something with those images, there's a couple of options. So you could right click on each one, choose save picture, give it a name, and click on save. Now that's fine if you got one or two, but what happens if you got plenty of images in this document? I'm going to show you a quicker way. So here is what you're going to be doing. Save your document, go to where the document is saved, make a copy of that document. Right click copy and then paste it. So now you have a duplicate copy of the document. Now here's where it gets interesting. Rename the copy of the document with an extension zip, Z-I-P. Once you do that, it changes the extension from a .docx to zip. Now it looks like a normal zip file, compressed file. Double click on it. Here you'll see a whole bunch of folders. Go onto your document, go onto the folder called Media, and ta-da, here are all your images nicely saved for you. Now, did you know that in Word you have the ability to draw on top of a document? It's not there by default, so what you got to do is right click the top, customize it, and on the right side you'll see all your ribbons that you have available to you, all the commands. One of them is called draw. Put a tick in there, click OK, and now it adds another menu called draw. So you open up the document, click on draw, and then select either the highlighter to highlight sections or the pen if you want to doodle something, very much like you would do in the real world had you printed it out. So, you know, if you have a document and you send it to somebody else and they make changes, but they forget to enable the feature called track changes, it makes it a little bit difficult to compare the old version to the new version. What did they change? What didn't they change? Go to review, go to compare. Here, you'll select the document. You select the original document. And next up, you select the new document that you were sent back. And when you click on OK, it will now highlight on the screen the changes that between the two documents. Now this is pretty cool, especially if you've got legal documents or documents which are pages after pages after pages that were sent back for you to simply sign. Just run them through the system and see that nothing else was changed that you didn't agree to originally. Having a date on a document is pretty standard and pretty common. We use them a lot in invoices, in proposals, in letters. You always want to have the date. So typically you would just simply type out the date, and next time you sent out the letter, you would just type that day's date. Well, thankfully you don't have to do that anymore. All you're going to do now is simply select the location where you'd like the date inserted. Click on insert from your menu options. On the ribbon bar, choose an option called date and time. And now, don't forget to check the box that says update automatically. And click OK. From this point, anytime you open the document, it will simply put that day's date. If you happen to need to translate your document into other languages, you can obviously use an external service, but you can also use Google Translate, which many of us do, but that requires a copy and paste to go in and out of the document. Well, in Word, it's got a built-in translator. Check this out. So you have your document. All you're going to do now is you're going to highlight the sentence or the phrase that needs to be translated. Click on Review and click on Translate. Now you can translate a section or entire document. We're going to choose just a selection. And on the right side, it will ask us what language do you want to translate it from and to? So here I translate it from English to Afrikaans in this case, or I can choose any of these languages straight from within Word. Once you select your language, it will translate it on the side there, and then you click on insert and it will put into the document. And it does work back and forth, kind of English to Spanish, Spanish to English in this case. Just a quick word of caution, I did translate it to a couple of languages that I do speak, and it did a pretty okay job. It wasn't perfect. So as with any translation between one language and another, just take it with a pinch of salt and just be wary.
Right, so that takes care of another episode of Tech Tip Tuesday, where every Tuesday we make tech simple for you. Did I miss out anything? Is there anything I should be adding to these tips? Please share in the comments below. Give it a thumbs up if you liked what you saw. It really helps the channel out a lot. If there's anything you didn't like, please let me know as well. Feel free to leave it in the comments. You're going to anyway. Share this video with somebody else who might need this kind of technology and this kind of tips, who wants to be more efficient with their system. And I'll see you guys next week. Cheers for now. We'll be right back.